Now we have another presenter who will share his work into science. He is from Germany and he's from Leipzig University of Applied Sciences. His name is Timo Hoffmann.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome to my presentation about local Lyapunov exponents of chaotic Hamiltonian systems. My name is Timo Hoffmann and I'm from Leipzig, which is located in Germany. Let me first introduce myself. Here you can see my inspirations for doing research. First of all, I think doing research is challenging and satisfying at the same time. And out there are so much unknown which can be discovered. And doing that, I want to make a contribution to science, especially in the fields of physics and mathematics. And that way, I want to further the course of knowledge. But on the other hand, I also want to follow my father's footprints because he is a mathematician too. I think the given quote by Goethe's Faust, that I may know what the world contains in its innermost heart and finer veins, sums up really good what a scientist has to be like also today. Here you can see some of my achievements. I took regularly part in competitions in the field of mathematics, physics and chemistry during my school time in my hometown, Leipzig, as well as in my federal state and nationwide. And besides that, I took part in some international competitions and I was able to publish the research I'm going to present here in 2018. I was always interested in natural sciences, so I attended a special grammar school called Wilhelm Oswald Gymnasium, which is focused on natural sciences. And I took recently up my studies at Leipzig University in the field of mathematics. Okay, now let me come to my research topic. First, there's the question, what is chaos? And there are two signs for the detection of chaos. On the one hand, you have the sensitive dependence of the initial values, and on the other hand, you have a mixing of the solution curves. And then there arises the question, how to measure the chaoticity of a system? And one way to do that are the so-called Lyapunov exponents, and they describe the velocity of the divergence of two trajectories that start closely adjacent, and roughly speaking, a Lyapunov exponent, lambda, describes the rate of the time development of the distance of two points of the phase space, which is small at the beginning. That means it measures the velocity of the, or it measures the dependence of the initial values. And what you see, if the Lyapunov exponent lambda is bigger than zero, your trajectories diverge, which means there can be chaos. But on the other hand, if lambda is smaller than zero, they converge, and that means there can be no chaos. Okay, now let me introduce a low-dimensional example, the so-called Hanon-Hale system. It describes the movement of a galaxy around the galactic center, for example, and it is described by the Hamiltonian, which can be found here. That is the whole energy of the system, and that means it has to be constant. And yeah, here you can see some solution curves to the same energy level of that system. And now I increase the energy slowly, and you can see how they change. And up to that point, there is no chaos yet. But if I increase the energy more, there will arise chaos. As you can see here, the yellow trajectory becomes chaotic. And if you increase the energy even more, more and more trajectories become chaotic. And if I increase the energy more, then there are nearly all trajectories chaotic, except, for example, the green one here. Yes. In my further research, I studied some symmetries of such systems and some further properties of these systems. By doing that, I got a good insight into the topic, and I think it is really interesting. Thank you for your attention.
Wow, wow, wow. High fives handed out. More applause all the way here. Yes. Thank you so much for this presentation. Or danke schön, as you say in Germany.
Danke.
Danke, danke. How, yeah, I'm learning languages here step by step. We can probably combine it. How does it feel to be in this science? I'm so amazed by you. As I said before, when I met all of you, I literally got goosebumps just talking with the guys when I had all in front of them. And of course, I get goosebumps from you guys as well. We're all amazing in our own way. But holy mac, it's so much like knowledge. And so like, how do you get your passion and your...
As I mentioned, my father is a mathematician too. And yeah, as a young boy, you want to become like your father. And it hasn't changed yet. So I still want to become a mathematician. And it is really interesting.
Yeah, since sixth class, you said as well, you started to take extra mathematics.
Yes, yeah.
That's amazing. We will see if there's someone in the audience who has some question as well. If it's anything you want to ask Timo here, you can just raise your hand, and then we have people here who will go out with the microphones. Anyone who would like to ask something to Timo here? We see some people are smiling, some people are looking, and some people are fixing their hair. So it's a halfway up. Another one, yeah. We hold it like there for now. Then I would like to say like this, in the future, where are you heading in the future? Like, you say that you want to like become more like your father or so, but yeah. Your work and your next mission, like in this.
I want to work in a university, for example, as a professor.
Mm-mm-mm.
Yeah.
Is it Leipzig University then, or?
I hope so.
I hope so. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not Münster University, yeah.
No.
No, not that. No. Not that good, yeah. No. I've just been visit there once, but it was bad. No, I'm just kidding. It was really good. it was fantastic university, yeah. But Leipzig then. Then we all encourage and support Timo for his way to go to Leipzig University. Thank you so much once
Thank
again.
You.
Yeah. I can take this here as well. Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah.